गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू हैव वॉच्ड वीडियो ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ सेकेंड लेसन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द सेकेंड पार्ट. इन दिस वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बहामनी किंगडम एंड अबाउट मुगल एम्पायर. द बहामनी किंगडम. हियर यू कैन सी मैप ऑफ इंडिया इन विच बहामनी किंगडम इज हाईलाइटेड. While Muhammad bin Tughlaq was still reigning, some of his sardars in the Deccan rose in rebellion against him. The leader of these sardars, Hasan Gangu, defeated the army of the Sultan in Delhi. A new kingdom known as the Bahamani Kingdom came into existence. In 1347 CE, Hasan Gangu became the first Sultan of the Bahamani Kingdom. He made the city of Gulbarga in Karnataka his capital. Mahmud Gawan. Mahmud Gawan was the chief wazir of the Bahamani Kingdom. He was a good administrator, that is, ruler. He strengthened the Bahamani Kingdom. He started paying the soldiers their salaries in cash instead of through land grants. He brought discipline in the army. He introduced many reforms in the land revenue system. He opened a madrasa. Madrasa means a type of school where children of Muslim community study at Bidar for Arabic and Persian studies. After the death of Mahmud Gawan, factionism that is started dividing into small group increased among the Bahamani Sardars. The conflict with the Vijayanagar kingdom had an adverse, that is, terrible effect on the Bahamani kingdom. The provincial, that is, regional governors began to act more independently. This led to the disintegration of the Bahamani kingdom into five small powers: Imad Shahi of Warhad, Barid Shahi of Bidar, Adil Shahi of Bijapur, Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar, and Qutub Shahi of Golconda. Now let us study about Mughal power. In 1526 CE, the Sultanate of Delhi came to an end. Mughal power was established there. Babur. Babur was the founder of Mughal power. He was the king of Fergana in Central Asia, in today's Uzbekistan. He had heard of the wealth in India, so he planned an invasion of India. Invasion is attack. The reigning Sultan of Delhi at that time was Ibrahim Lodi. Daulat Khan Lodi was the governor of Punjab under the Sultanate. The relationship between Ibrahim Lodi and Daulat Khan was strained, that is, not good. Daulat Khan Lodi invited Babur to march on India. Taking this opportunity, Babur invaded India. To repel, that is, push back Babur's invasion, Ibrahim Lodi started with his army. There was a battle between Ibrahim Lodi and Babur on 21st April 1526 at Panipat. In this battle, Babur made use of an artillery effectively for the first time in India. He defeated Ibrahim Lodi's army. This is known as the First Battle of Panipat. After the Battle of Panipat, Rana Sanga of Mewad brought all Rajput kings together. There was a battle between Babur and Rana Sanga at Khanwa. Babur's artillery means big guns or cannon, you can see in the picture, and reversed force played a key role in this battle, and Rana Sanga's army was defeated. Babur died in 1530 CE. Now let us study about successor of Babur. Babur came to India in 1526 CE. After Babur, Humayun from 1530 CE to 1539 CE and from 1555 CE to 1556 CE ascended the throne. He was defeated by Sher Shah. Sher Shah established the Sur dynasty on the throne of Delhi. After Humayun, Akbar in 1556 CE to 1605 CE ascended the throne. There was a battle between Akbar and Hemu at Panipat in 1556 CE. This is the second battle of Panipat. Akbar's ambition was to bring the whole of India under his one central authority. After Akbar, Jahangir from 1605 CE to 1628 CE became the emperor. During his reign, his wife Nur Jahan played an active role in the administration. Jahangir was followed by Shahjahan in 1628 CE to 1658 CE as the emperor. The next emperor after Shahjahan, Aurangzeb, from 1658 CE to 1707 CE reigned for a very long time. After his death, the Mughal emperor became weak. Akbar was the most powerful king of the Mughal dynasty. When he tried to bring India under his central authority, he had to face opposition Maharana Pratap, Chand Bibi, Rani Durgavati struggled against him. Their strength is noteworthy. Now we will see about struggle of Maharana Pratap. After the death of Uday Singh, Maharana Pratap ascended the throne of Mewad. He continued the struggle for Mewad's existence. Till the very end, he struggled with Akbar to maintain his independence. He has become immortal in history due to his qualities of valor, that is bravery, courage, self-respect, sacrifice, etc. Chand Bibi. The Mughals attacked Ahmednagar, the capital of Nizam Shah's kingdom, in 1595 CE. The Mughal army put the fort of Ahmednagar under siege. Sages surrounded the fort with military power. Chand Bibi, the capable daughter of Hussein Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar, bravely defended the fort. At this time, there was an internal strife, that is conflict, among the factions of the Sardars in Nizam Shahi's kingdom. This resulted in the murder of Chand Bibi. Later, the Mughals captured the fort of Ahmednagar, but the Mughals could not bring the entire kingdom of Nizam Shahi under their control. Rani Durgavati. Gondwana can broadly be said to comprise the eastern part of Vidarbha, part of Madhya Pradesh to its north, the western part of today's Chhattisgarh, northern part of Andhra Pradesh, and the western part of Odisha. Durgavati, born in the dynasty Chandel Rajput, became the queen of Gondwana when she was married. She was an excellent administrator. The struggle of Gondwana Queen Durgavati against the Mughals is important in medieval history. After her husband's death, Durgavati laid down her life while fighting against Akbar, but she did not surrender. Akbar was well versed, that is knowledgeable and vigilant, that is alert or attentive ruler. His religious policy was liberal and tolerant. He gave equal treatment to people from all religions. He founded Din-e-Ilahi by incorporating noble principles from all religions, but never compelled anyone to adopt Din-e-Ilahi. Din-e-Ilahi was new religion formed by Akbar. It was mixture of various religions, but main thoughts were taken from Hinduism and Islam. Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb won the wars of succession amongst other sons of Shahjahan and became the emperor by detaining his father in 1658 CE. Dara Suko, the elder son of Shahjahan, was famous for religious tolerance. He translated more than 50 Upanishads in Persian language when Aurangzeb became the emperor. At that time, the Mughal Empire extended from Kashmir in the north up to Ahmednagar in the south and from Kabul in the west up to Bengal in the east. To this, Aurangzeb added Assam in the east and the regions of Adilshahi of Bijapur in the south and Qutub Shahi of Golconda after he ended these kingdoms. Conflicts of Aurangzeb with the Ahoms. In the 13th century CE, the people of the Shan community settled down in the valley of river Brahmaputra. They established their kingdom there. They were locally known as Ahom people. While Aurangzeb ruled, the Ahoms had a prolonged struggle with the Mughals. The Mughals attacked the Ahoms region. The Ahoms united under the leadership of Gadadhar Sinha, Commander Lachit Borphukan, gave an intense battle against the Mughals. The Ahoms used the guerrilla techniques in the conflict against the Mughals. It became impossible for Mughals to create a strong base in Assam. Conflict with the Sikhs. The ninth guru of the Sikhs, Guru Tegh Bahadur, protested strongly against Aurangzeb's policy of religious intolerance. Aurangzeb imprisoned him and beheaded him in 1675 CE. After him, Guru Gobind Singh became the guru of the Sikhs. Guru Gobind Singh organized his followers and encouraged their martial spirit. Martial spirit is the spirit of war or fight. He organized the Sikh youths into a fighting force called the Khalsa Dal. Their headquarters were at Anandpur. Aurangzeb sent his army to fight the Sikhs. His army attacked Anandpur. Although the Sikhs fought fiercely, that is bravely or strongly, they did not succeed. After that, Guru Gobind Singh came to the Deccan in 1708 CE. There was an attempt on his life, that is attack on his life, when he was at Nanded. Soon after, the Guru succumbed to his wounds, that is died due to his injuries. Conflict with the Rajputs. Akbar had secured the cooperation of Rajputs with his policy of amicable, that is friendly relations. Aurangzeb could not obtain the cooperation of Rajputs. After the death of Rana Jaswant Singh of Marwad, Aurangzeb annexed, that is joined his kingdom to the Mughal Empire. दुर्गादास राठौड़ क्राउंड जसवंत सिंह माइनर सन अजीत सिंह एज द किंग ऑफ मारवाड़। दुर्गादास राठौड़ फॉट हार्ड अगेंस्ट द मुगल्स। औरंगजेब सेंड प्रिंस अकबर टू मारवाड़ टू क्रश द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दुर्गादास। प्रिंस अकबर जॉइन हैंड्स दैट इज मेड फ्रेंडशिप विद राजपूत्स एंड रोज इन रिवॉल्ट अगेंस्ट औरंगजेब। एंड एफर्ट्स वॉज मेड टू सीक हेल्प फ्रॉम द मराठास इन महाराष्ट्र। इन दिस रिवॉल्ट दुर्गादास राठौड़ कंटिन्यू द स्ट्रगल अगेंस्ट द मुगल्स फॉर द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ मारवाड़। Conflicts with the Marathas. In Maharashtra, Swaraj was established under the leadership of Shivaji Maharaj. In his efforts to establish Swaraj, Shivaji Maharaj had to fight the Mughals too along with the other enemies. Aurangzeb came down to the Deccan after the death of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj with the intention of conquering the whole of South India. But the Marathas offered stiff resistance to Aurangzeb and defended their independence. We shall study this struggle later on. So here we have completed with the lesson. Now, let us recap today's lesson. In today's lesson, we first studied about the Bahamani Kingdom and work of Mahmud Gawan. Then we studied about invasion of Babur. Other than this, we studied about struggle of Maharana Pratap, Chand Bibi and Rani Durgavati with Akbar. Besides this, we studied about rule of Aurangzeb in India and his conflicts with the Ahoms, the Rajputs, the Sikhs and with the Marathas. Thank you.